are going to do a little 40 challenge between Andrea and I. So I am Laura from Front Office Rocks. We do online front office training, and I've been an office manager since 2002, and I'm here with Andrea. So why don't you tell everybody who you are, Andrea?
Hi, everybody. So I'm Andrea Greer. I have On Point Space is the name of my company, and I work with dental practices and dental professionals to elevate their workspaces. So whether it's their practice or their home office or their doctor's private office, I help them with decor and organization.
Awesome. So Andrea and I have done a lot of courses together, a lot of training for clients, because I believe that patients don't know whether you're a good dentist or not. I don't know that they know your clinical skill. I believe that how your team, the experience that your team gives them, the way they feel in the office matters. And so I'm all about training your front office team on verbal skills and systems and giving the patient amazing experience. Andrea is also on the same page with me, but she talks a lot more about the environment and the space. And we were chit-chatting probably over a glass of wine or something recently.
Probably.
And we were saying, you know, there's so many dentists who come to us and team members who are saying that their marketing's not working. You know, they're not getting enough new patients, or maybe they're not getting enough referrals. And we thought, well, there's more to it than just the marketing. Have you looked around at your team? Have you looked at how they answer the phones? Have you looked at the space that you're in? So we decided, why not have a little challenge to go through fast tips that you can take back to your practice today. We had to make it a challenge because Andrea and I could sit and talk about this for about 3 or 4 hours, and we knew you guys didn't have that much time. So what we're doing is minute tips back and forth. Andrea gets a minute, I get a minute. Andrea gets a minute, I get a minute. And we're going to go through 40 things that we think are important for your practice. We are trying to be high tech, but we're going to go old school. I'm going to count us down on this. Exactly.
So I am like you.
All right. So Andrea, I'll start the timer for you when you're up. And then when you're done with a minute, ding, 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 you stop. I'll do the next tip and you count for me. Sound good?
All right.
All right, guys. And if you're watching, you want to share it and tell other people to get on, please do, because this will be a lot of fun.
This is going to be a lot.
All right. Awesome. 40 things that your practice is saying about you without you even knowing. That's what we're talking about. Andrea, I'm going to let you start with number one. So you ready?
I'm ready.
All right, go.
All right. The first thing that I think is really, really important is that we have to understand how big of an impact this does have on our patients. So first impressions are everything. Within that first 7 seconds, people are judging us and they're deciding whether we are going to be the practice for them and their family. Obviously, like Laura said, they cannot judge us by our technical skills. They don't know if we do great work. They are basing their entire judgment on how we make them feel. So it's all about that experience, and that is the heart, that how we make them feel is the heart of the patient experience. Am I beat the clock?
You did. You're ahead of, we're going to get this one done early. All right.
All right. Ready?
Yep, I'm good.
Go.
Okay, so mine is similar to Andrea's, but mine is more about communication with the team and making sure that the team understands the importance of this. Because many times, doctors, you're in the back, you're doing clinical things, your hygienist assistants are in the back, but the whole team has an impact on what patients see. You know, the clutter around the office and the way they talk and the way they dress and how they respond to things and the nonverbal communication. And so it's important that you and your team have communication, talk about these things on a regular basis, and realize that patients are judging you from the moment you walk in, whether it's good or bad, they're judging you and your team. And it really has no impact on your dentistry, but it's important that you and your team value the importance of it for the patients. 1 second to
awesome.
Go.
Awesome.
All right. So that's tip number two. What do you have for number three, Andrea?
All right. So I always talk to teams when I'm working with them about really putting on their patient eyes and walking through the practice. And I really believe that that starts in the parking lot. So we know that on the phone is really important for patient experience and the website is really important for patient experience. But when we're actually looking at the physical presence of the patient in the practice, it starts in the parking lot. So what does that look like? Is there trash blowing around and out there? What does the landscaping look like? What is the signage? Do they have good signage? Is it easy to find? it's amazing how many practices we'll go to that are actually kind of hard to find because the signage is either limited based on their leases or whatever, and we have to take that into consideration. You should have a great map on your Google, on your website as well. I've been lost trying to get to clients' offices because their Google, their website doesn't have the right map. So, yeah.
Awesome. Good one. Oh, okay. I need to stop it now. It's making noise. Shh. Okay. All right. Ready. Great. So I'm tagging on Andrea on everyone. So Andrea was talking about outside your practice in the parking lot. And I actually can attest to that. Our dental office was right next to a bar. And so every Monday morning, the parking lot was full of beer cans and cigarette butts. And I know it's a responsibility of the bar, but patients are judging us. So we would go out there with gloves and clean up the parking lot. My next thing is your signage, meaning when somebody drives by your office, what does it say? A huge pet peeve of mine is when you drive by and it says dentist. That's it, dentist. So I know there's a dentist there, but I don't know who you are. I don't know anything. I mean, you're the Vons dentist. You're the Safeway dentist. Who are you? So I know that you may not be able to fully change your sign tomorrow or you know, change what's on the building, but find a way to stand out, whether you have to put it in the window or on the front door, or if you can get the sign changed. Because if you're being the Apple, the dental floss, the logo, the dancing toothbrush logo, and you say dentist, you're not standing out from anybody else. And they're just thinking you're just one of many, and you need to go beyond that. So look at that dentist and see what you can do to make yourself set apart. Did I go over or am I good?
A little bit. That's okay. All right.
You took the phone away.
We've got time to spare. We're doing good.
Okay, good. So that was my number four. You are now on number five.
Yeah. All right. So what can you do about the entryway? So I'm still outside. I'm not even inside the practice yet. And I'm looking at the entryway. Do we have like old paper taped signs up in the window? Do we have bugs in the ceiling light? Every single practice, when you go, there's a light typically above the door. And many, many times there are bugs all caked in there with spider webs and cobwebs, and it's just gross. Are the windows dirty? What does that look like? So like you said, what is what's the trash situation out there? So always picking that up. Landscaping. I know a lot of people lease their space and they don't have control necessarily over the landscaping, but if there's dead landscaping, your landlord is never going to be upset if you clean a little bit of that out. And in fact, if you show that you're willing to invest your time, oftentimes they're willing to invest a little bit of money too. So that can be helpful. Approach your landlord.
All right.
Oh, hang on. All right. Okay.
We had a fancy timer set up, but you got to wait. All right. So mine is the signs, and Andrea's going to talk more about it, but I'm talking about on the windows outside. I live in Southern California, so we have the highest number of dentists in, you know, per capita. There's a ton of competition, and I walk down these strip malls where there's dentists, and they have posters up that look like they got put up in like 1995. They're faded, they're gross. Like you said, there's bugs in them. When I walk by, it just grosses me out, and you probably don't see it. It's behind the blinds, or it's behind the patient chairs or reception area, but people are looking at that when they walk by your office. So make sure that if you have to put signs in the window, I'm not saying that you even need them out there, because people aren't looking at a picture of a happy, smiling family going, oh, that's going to be me if I go to this dentist. But if you do feel like you need signs, clean them up, and they fade fast in the sun. So get them out, put a new one up, and keep it fresh so that people know that your office cares and that your dentistry is clean and your office is clean.
Right.
Exactly. All right. On to you. Ready?
All right. All right. So now we can head inside. So walk into your practice, and it's important to really, as I said earlier, put on your patient eyes. So pretend you've never walked in your practice before. And then as you, for every position that you take as you're walking through the practice, you're going to look up, look down, look left, and look right. So always look around fully. People don't have tunnel vision. They're looking everywhere in the practice. Sit in every single chair that's in your reception area and do the same thing, because different chairs have different views. And you're also trying to ascertain if those are worn out. Is the padding kind of worn out? Because if they're not comfortable, it's not that we want people to be comfortable because they're going to be there a long time, right? Hopefully. But we do want them to always feel like it's comfortable to be in your practice. So it is important that those chairs are definitely maintained.
Good job.
All right.
All right. So now I'm talking about similar to what Andrea's talking about the entryway and walking in, but I'm talking now about the employee behind that front desk. Mm-hmm. And does the team member make eye contact with the patient when they walk in or the person when they walk in? Do they welcome them to the office? Do they have a body language that actually supports that welcome, right? Are they slouched and are they kind of rolling their eyes like, welcome to the office?
Or ignoring them.
Or ignoring them, exactly. Or are they excited to see them? And when the patient walks in, I mean, God forbid you actually have the sign in, sit down form. Please don't have that. But even if you like welcome them in and then they sit down in the reception area, they're your responsibility in that reception area. Ask them how their day's going. Find out how their last trip was. Like your work in front of you is not as important as that patient in the reception area, because that's not only their impression, but over time, if they don't feel they're welcome in your practice, they can very easily go to another dental office. So always, always, always make sure the patient feels welcome the moment they walk in your practice.
Absolutely.
Okay, so it's your turn. Yes. You're number nine.
I'm on number nine.
Go for it.
It's our favorite word, Laura. What is it? It's sinusitis.
Can't even say it. Say it again.
Sinusitis.
Sinusitis. Okay.
Sinusitis. Signs as a means of communication. Terrible idea. So I'm talking about the signs that say payment is due in full at the time of service, or please tell us if you have insurance, or changes in your insurance or addresses, or, you know.
No show cancellation fees.
Oh my gosh, you guys, that's the worst form of communication. And patients feel, I got to tell you, when I walk into an office and I see that as the main form of communication, I automatically get a very negative feeling about it, about the office, that they want to hide behind just, this is our policy, rather than explaining to me why it's in my best interest to follow those policies, right? So there's got to be a lot of verbal skills and people being on the same page in order to make that successful, but signs are not a good way to communicate.
I agree with that, for sure. Okay, mine is going to be, and I spoke to it a minute ago a little bit, but the nonverbal communication of your team members. You know, 60% of a message comes from nonverbal. So I even hear this when I call into dental offices. One of my jokes is I called into an office once and she's like, it's a sunny day here at ABC Dental. And I'm like, no, it's not. I could tell it's kind of cloudy over there. You know, I might say the things I've been taught to say, like, welcome to the office. But if I'm slouched, if I'm rolling my eyes, if I'm sighing, that's the impression you're giving patient. That outweighs what you say. And it's not even just the person greeting the patient, but like Andrea said, they can see all around your practice. So if these people are over, your team members are whispering, and this person's rolling their eyes, slamming instruments, and the doctor's over here upset about something, the patients can see that. So be very, very conscious of what they can see. And honestly, my suggestion is fix what's going on in the practice so that you don't have these negative nonverbal communication in any way, because it's not good for the patients and it's really not good for the team. So just figure out ways to get rid of it altogether.